It's really nice to see that, you know, bang at 3 o'clock, we have 38 people on board. And I'm sure there'll be many more who will be joining as we go forward. A starting request is that each one, if you could, for those of you who have not displayed your name, and you know, please display your name and your company name also, preferably, so that we play this knowing game a little bit more intensely. COSMA, as many of you would know, is the Control Panel and Switchgear Manufacturers Association. Now, this association, it was started in the year 1988, and we are very fortunate to have Mr. Satish Kazi, who was one of the founder, you know, founders of COSMA. And the whole genesis of COSMA was in the fact that, you know, when panel builders were used to meet in customers' locations or consultants' locations, there would generally be a sense of animosity, you know, particularly, "Arey, mera order ye kich ke ja raha hai," and this emotion which came up, you know, there were these four panel builders who got together and said, "Can we change this emotion?" You know, and the best way to change an emotion is to transform it. So competitors came forward and said that let's become collaborators. And that is how COSMA was formed. So in COSMA, we believe that when we come together, and if we can stay together, then we can all grow together. And this is the belief system with which we feel that, you know, we must all support each other, learn along with each other, grow together, have each other's shoulders to, you know, support, as well as for people to cry on, as the case may be. We go for factory visits together. We have such webinars together, so on and so forth. Tomorrow, should there be a kind of a threat which comes to our company from outside, like presently we all seem to be having this threat about the manner in which the prices are increasing, whether it is CRCA or metals, copper, aluminium. Now, is there something which we can do together to survive through this kind of a phase? If there be, God forbid, a governmental rule which can threaten our very existence, then can we, you know, the idea is that we can all quickly join together and then see how we can work together to solidify what is fair to all concerned. So this is the whole premise of COSMA. And the whole purpose of COSMA is also that we need to grow in India. And that's something which we are all, we've come together with a strong resolve for. Why? Because we believe that in unity, there is strength. In coming together, there is a lot more that we can achieve than just being in our own isolated islands. So the whole purpose of this webinar is not just to learn from, you know, stalwarts like Socomec, where recently we had Ms. Aman Verma, who's also here, who spoke to us about his product range of Entis. And there are many more such webinars lined up. But also use this opportunity for people who are non-members to get a peep into what COSMA is all about. How does this help them? In what way will they benefit? And how can this coming together, you know, really solidify ourselves as a force to reckon with in the industry? So there are a lot of consolidations happening in the industry, as we know. Schneider has, you know, really increased its strength tremendously by having acquired L&T. Siemens has similarly done it with acquiring C&S, and ABB similarly with GE. So all these consolidations, when it is happening, then, you know, we as panel builders will also need to equally consolidate ourselves so that we will be able to ensure that justice is meted out to each one at all points of time. So here is an invitation for those of you who are not COSMA members to go into cosmaindia.co.in. This is the website of COSMA. So once you go into cosmaindia.co.in, you will be able to understand more about COSMA. And then there is also the membership details and the membership form, which you could fill up and then, you know, become a member of COSMA. So having said that, I would, you know, really, I'm very glad to have Socomec here with all of us today. Deepesh from Kerala, our vice chairman there, has taken a lot of initiative to organize this seminar. It was initially intended for the you know, beautiful state of Kerala, but then we said, why don't we expand it to an all India basis so that it can become more of a knowledge sharing, and that is where we are today. So thank you, Deepesh, for all the efforts you have taken to make this seminar happen. Socomec is a company which is very close to my heart personally. We are, you know, in my trading company Money Sales, we are authorized stockists for Socomec, as well as we use Socomec products in load controls, our panel building division. And it's a company which stands by principles. It's a company which has got quality products, and it, and you know, when these kind of technologies come to India, the beauty is that India as a country also has so much to learn from these technologies, and then, you know, as a world, we all progress. So let me not you know, stand between you and the beautiful seminar which awaits us. Back to Anand.
Thank you, Mr. Ramani. Over to Deepesh for the introduction of Socomec speakers.
Thank you, sir. And sir. Thank you for giving an opportunity to introduce our speakers. Also, I would take this opportunity to express my gratitude to Socomec, especially South team, Mr. Suresh Babu, Chitra Madam, and Ganesh. You know, they have taken a good effort to make it happen. Good afternoon all. And it is a great pleasure for me to introduce Mr. Vikram Dhingra, General Manager, Sales and Marketing, Socomec India. Mr. Vikram holds a bachelor degree in electrical engineering from National Institute of Technology and postgraduate diploma business management from IPM with a wide industry experience of 25 years. Prior to Socomec, Vikram held a pan-India business unit head role with Kirloskar Oil Engines for a short duration. His major past experience was with L&T for 14 years in pan-India commercial leadership position in LV switchgear business. And he has also worked with other organizations like Bharatiya Cutler Hammer and Crop and Greaves Limited for about 12 years. Yes. Welcome, Mr. Vikram, sir. We are waiting for your speech. Thank you.
Vikram,
you've got to unmute yourself, Vikram.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for the nice introduction, Mr. Satish Kaji. Chairman COSMA, Mr. Ramani, Director, Deepesh Bhai, Vice Chairman South Chapter, Mr. Sudhir, Director, Mr. Vishal Sangvi, Mr. Anand Jaivan, Director, COSMA, and esteemed dignitaries from COSMA, ladies and gentlemen, a very, very good afternoon to all of you.
Good afternoon.
It gives me really immense pleasure in extending a very, very warm welcome to all of you from our Socomec family, Socomec India, on this digital event. I see a really beautiful analogy between COSMA and the word cosmos, which I just heard, which means an orderly and harmonious universe of stars and planets. And that's what Mr. Kaji, the COSMA founders, have brought all the stars, all the major control panel manufacturers under one platform, under one common umbrella. So today we are really delighted to connect with all such stars. Like COSMA, Socomec also believes in adding value for customers with quality of products and solutions. We are a leading global specialist in low voltage switchgear, especially in power switching and monitoring products. And we are committed to constantly innovate and improve the energy performance in sectors in installations like in infra, industry, and other commercial sites. This group is almost 98 years old, and soon we'll be completing 100th year of our launch. And we are present in more than 80 countries, which will be shared with you in our subsequent session. And SOCOMAC is a way ahead of more general solution providers than we are specialists. Rather, we are a specialist, and we are better positioned by constantly anticipating market challenges or market changes and developing cutting edge technologies and ensure complete compliance with international standards. So today, we also would like to take you through these international and Indian standards through our TSC range. These product, which TSC range we call, which gets compliance with all these standards. So I once again thank you, all of you, for joining this event, giving us the opportunity to present SOCOMAC on this webinar. And with this, I would like to hand over the proceedings to my colleagues, Vikas and Anis. Thank you very much.
Hello. Let me introduce Mr. Vikas.
Yes, Deepesh bhai. You can introduce Mr. Vikas.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Vikas Kumar Tyagi, with an overall 28-year experience, rich experience in marketing and business development, Vikas Kumar Tyagi has been associated with SOCOMAC Innovative Power Solutions as marketing head for the last 10 years, overseeing operational efficiencies and market development. Besides, he is responsible for new product level development, market strategy, market research, product development and management, field segment marketing, offer management and customer service. Here, he will be introducing new product with new features. That's okay. Mr. Vikas bhai, you can proceed.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for giving the opportunity to present a few elements from the SOCOMAC solutions. I hope I'm audible to all of you.
Yeah, perfect. Go ahead.
Thank you, sir. So thanks to COSMA series of technical webinars, the topic for today is a seminar on transfer switch equipment by SOCOMAC. And I would begin introduce you to some interesting concepts and followed by my colleague Anish Gopalakrishnan, who would carry on with the balance part. So I do hope that all of you continue to be safe and sound, sincerely wishing that you would continue enjoying good health and well-being of your family and friends. A very good afternoon and a warm welcome to the eminent personalities and associated with COSMA organization, along with the venerable members in the audience. It's indeed a privilege to get an opportunity to share the important insights into switch-based PC class auto transfer switch, along with key attributes and benefits as compared to other conventional methodologies. So the part one of the webinar content would comprise the new generation of our transfer switching equipment that are compliant to IEC 60947-6-1, also to IEC 60947-3, that happen to be de facto standards for transfer switching and for load switching with isolation respectively. And all this is aimed for high uptime of the installation and for eventual safety. So we would include the introduction about SOCOMAC IC product standards and the types of transfer, because different methodologies are there. The SOCOMAC TSC technology, because globally, the word changeover is being replaced by transfer switching equipment. Then the SOCOMAC manual transfer switching range as well. So coming over to the SOCOMAC introduction, as already covered by Mr. Vikram Dhingra very comprehensively, we are basically a pioneer and a specialist in low voltage electrical switching and transfer switching energy monitoring, and as well as in power conversion products. It's a French family-owned entity, almost 100 years in existence, with a truly global footprint spanning the entire globe. Out of 29 subsidiaries, there are at least 10 subsidiaries that are in Asia alone that shows the vision of SOCOMAC in developing this region and the expected growth opportunities in the coming decades. We have installation-based market knowledge and perspective associated with data center, healthcare, energy, infrastructure, industry, as well as building segments. So our expertise falls in five different verticals. One is the power switching, which includes load switching, transfer switching, both automatic as well as manual. Power monitoring is into the energy metering as well as energy management systems, along with some unique plug and play solutions. Power conversion is about UPS, energy storage, and the battery systems, both modular as well as monolithic. Energy storage is a budding vertical where we have a very good footprint all across the globe, and we are seeing some good opportunities. We have some very good solutions, both for switching as well as inverter applications for energy storage. And expert services is actually more than just a service vertical. It does a lot more. There are audit facilities, there are maintenance contracts. So wherever we have installations, we have an expert services team taking care of that. Now, one very unique thing which you would find from this synopsis is that Socomec has been continually investing almost 10% of their turnover year after year in research and development. Now, this is truly an eye-opener. This is different from the other, I would say, commercial organizations. All the organizations today need to be commercial. There is the emphasis on top line, ROIs, bottom lines, all that. But at the same time, there are very few organizations which actually look at how we can actually look up at the future, innovate, and for that, there is investment required in R&D, which Socomec has been heavily into. And that's why we have a manufacturing footprint, which has been scattered all across at different strategic locations to be able to cater to the specific requirements. And a few milestones, as you see, is a glimpse of Socomec journey through the years, highlighting a few important landmark years, I would say. The company was founded almost 100 years back by Mr. Joseph Siat in the city of Benfeld, which is at the France-Germany border in the, I would say, in the extreme east part of France. The first industrial changeover switch was innovated by Socomec back in 1944. The first power testing laboratory was created in 65. And then this was followed by the introduction of the first isolation switch, Serco range, in 74. Then the first motorized transfer switch, almost, I would say, 33 years back. Launch of ATS in 2003. And 2021 has been, in between, there have been some very interesting milestones, but 2021 has been very unique in the sense that on one side, we introduced for the local market, indigenously developed and enhanced a new range of Sarkavar and also associated retrofit accessories. And now the new range of entry-level ATYS A and C integrated automatic transfer switches. So this is just a glimpse of the integrated test facility that Socomec has got. High capacity test platforms, accredited third party power test lab, which is authorized to give all major certifications, including UL, CSA, CCC, and KEMA. So it's an exclusive area with 50 test specialists, and all the tests, including environmental testing, high level short circuit, performance testing, environmental degradation, accelerated corrosion, all the different vagaries of tests on UPS and switching is done for all the international clients. Now, coming to Socomec India, we have been around here since 1992 with a state-of-the-art manufacturing facility in Gurgaon. And there are offices in almost all the major metro cities, highly skilled workforce, and an expert care 24/7 hotline. And we are having partners covering all the states and more than 25,000 installations. We also have a dedicated service partner network. So as you can see, there are at present for the power switching and monitoring range alone, there are close to 19 authorized service partners. This is to ensure that whenever we have the opportunity to be associated with our valued system integrators and panel builders, then we are able to give them the attentiveness and the speed of response which is needed in such cases, whether it is for switching, for metering, or any other integration with a third-party system. Socomec has been emphasizing on Make in India initiatives. So back in 2010, we introduced an indigenously developed auto transfer switch range for the OEM applications. And then this was followed by safety enclosure. This is some very unique solution, which is for areas with hazardous dust and maybe for cement plants and alumina smelters. So whereby it's a very unique solution. It has got a visible contact switch. Then in fact, it's a local power come control isolation. We all know for important motors in a big infrastructure like a cement plant where there are a couple of hundred, maybe more than 1,000 motors at a time, there's always a provision for a local control station. But this one incorporates not only control isolation, but also power isolation. So even a layman could be able to isolate in case of an emergency or for plant shutdowns without risk of any, that's why the name safety enclosure. So we have developed it locally for aluminium as well as copper connections, and we are one of the leading suppliers. And then we have the Serco and Sercover boost products, basically range of isolators, and then back-to-back isolator, which makes it a changeover switch and christened as Sercover range. Also, a range of UPS is being developed locally. Delphis Elite range up to 200 kVA. We also have modular solutions up to 600 kVA. And then we have, today Socomec has one of the biggest portfolios of photovoltaic isolators. In India today, we stand at a PV capacity of almost 40 gigawatt. And I'm pleased to share with you that we are associated with projects worth at least 15 gigawatt, where we have supplied our range of manual as well as motorized isolators, including isolators with trip for leading OEMs for some of the most prestigious projects. And our integrators are also exporting these devices. Then we have the medium range of UPS 10 to 160 kVA that's been locally developed. And finally, the ATYS A and C range of transfer switches. That's one of the most versatile, I would say optimized solution for automatic switching being developed locally. And Mr. Anish would be going more in detail about this product in his upcoming slides. Now, I would focus primarily on the IC product standard and the various types of transfer switching equipment. It's all about safety. As you can say, in this specific case, there are workers who are trying to, do some civil and mechanical work, and suddenly they have to countenance some unexpected situation, but there is a harness, and that's why their life gets saved. So eventually, it's about harness. Up till a few years back, the IC committee, of which, of course, some eminent members of Socomec product team are also members in Europe, they were of the view that any switch, whether it's for multi-source or single source, is having the same set of challenges. But of late, they realized that when it is a transfer switching, it has to necessarily comply with a dedicated standard because the challenges are different. And this standard is IEC 60947-6-1, which is multiple function equipment transfer switching. And this is applying to all the transfer switching equipment covering wherever there are two sources involved up to 1000 volt AC. The idea behind the standard formulation is the product characteristics and tests have to be made in order to ensure that the transfer switching equipment, what we call as ATS in common parlance, is safe for usage. Because after all, two supplies are involved. And this TSE standard involves manual transfer switching equipment. As the name indicates, it's manually operated on load. Remote transfer switching equipment, whereby there is a separate command, there is a separate controller, the intelligence sits elsewhere. And the integrated automatic transfer switching equipment, which has got built-in intelligence in the sense about the quality of power supply, about all the integrated timers, all the interlocks, electrical, mechanical, everything is there. So as you might all be already versed with, this is the typical symbol of the transverse switching equipment where we have two sources and the load. MTSC is for manual, RTSC is remote, ATSC is fully automatic transverse switching equipment. STSC is a totally different category, which complies with 62310, which talks about very fast solid state transfers, which are less than 3 milliseconds, which is only for data center and IT. So in ATSC, the idea is any critical load for important installation is always supported by UPS. When we talk about a continuous process and even in a data center or healthcare facility, there's always a UPS. But at the upstream of UPS, there has to be a device which is specialized for transfer, because as per the IC standard, the transfer and the protection have to be segregated. And I'll come to how it's about the applicability. MTSC is typically used, is extremely simple, where the power can be interrupted for some amount of time. And that's why you might all be aware the time criteria, how much time it takes to transfer in case of manual switch is not so much vocally specified. It's typically for non-critical applications and meant for redundancy sort of. Remote transfer switching equipment is where there's a separate controller. This controller could be either from Socomec, and sometimes there is a flexibility that the integrators can also try to tie up with maybe a genset controller. So the system allows that kind of flexibility. Though we prefer that the ATS works best with Socomec controllers, but there are situations maybe where the genset controller has got some electromechanical parameters and the integrators have less choice to go for a third party controller. And finally, we have the automatic transfer switches where there are two independent units built as a complete whole. And this is used where safety and more important than that is the power availability comes to the fore, because eventually I'll explain this in subsequent slides. What's most important for ATS is ensuring not only safety, but also enhanced power availability for a critical installation. The three classes within the MBIT, as I explained earlier, 60947-6-1 is the de facto standard for transfer switching. Within this class, there are different architectures. Now there is a class CC. For example, when we talk about low rating AMF panels, we are having contactor-based solutions. Now, with the contactor-based solutions, there has to be a separate short circuit protection device. The transfer switching equipment, which is made using contactors, is capable of making and withstanding overloads only. Then there is a second category, which is most commonly used when the current thresholds are high, maybe 400 amperes and above. We have a circuit breaker-based transfer switching system, which is good at making and breaking currents. And finally, we have the most specified and the most rugged class of switch disconnector based transfer switching equipment, which is known as the PC class. This is capable of making and intended to withstand the short circuit currents. Now, in my subsequent slides, I will try to give you some analysis about the relative strength of the PC class versus the other commonly used architecture. Now, this is a synopsis of the different types of classes. For example, left top, we have the contactor based where there's a twin contactor. The CB class is where we are having an ASTS type of system where we are having two MCCBs or ACBs, which are as per the designated wiring, along with controller, logic, and electromechanical interlocks on a mounting plate. So when it comes from an OEM, then it comes with all those accessories. And this is known as the CB class. There is a no class where, of course, the hybrid systems where integrators prefer to have their own solutions for involving circuit breakers, timers, auxiliary relays, and they make their own system, but unless it is tested as per -6-1, it doesn't follow the class of TSC as specified. We have the class PC, which is solenoid type contact. And then we have the class PC, which is about the twin switch disconnector. That's where Socomec is. So it's basically class PC, the most commonly specified class in the transfer switching equipment. And it is based on twin switch disconnector. And finally, lastly, we have the fast transfer possible through static transfer switch, which is anyway complying to 62310. It's no longer part of -6-1 because this is a solid state device used only for UPS. Now, I will focus on certain elements. As you can see, when we use a contactor-based transfer, then under short circuit withstand, the contactor contacts, supposing contactor is used without any short circuit protection device. And as per the -6-1 standard, if it is tested for short circuit withstand, as per the class PC ICW test, then they naturally the contacts would weld. It would be destroyed because it cannot pass in its own -6-1. The circuit breaker class is intended to trip and break the current and not withstand the short circuit for continuity. So if there is a trip, if there's a full load short circuit, as per the manufacturers, it is recommended that after a couple of such short circuits at the ICS level, the circuit breaker should be replaced. Because these both these classes, they are not meant for ICW testing. They are not meant for withstanding on the short circuit, which is the one which improves the availability of system. Class PC type, under the short circuit conditions, the contacts, as you can see, they are actually attractive to each other. That increases the pressure on the contacts and favor high availability performance. Whereas, as you can see in CB class, there is a repulsion. So the class of PC that improves power availability, and that is why it is the most specified worldwide. We will see the test sequences, as you can see, as per the IEC 60947-6-1. There are different tests which are specified. PCs, PC class, CCs, contactors, CBs, circuit breaker. As you can see, we have the different sequences for general performance, operating performance. And when we come to the verification of short circuit, then one very important criteria highlighted here in green, short time withstand. As you can see, as per IC, only PC class is specified. That means as per IC, as far as transfer switching is concerned, they do not consider that circuit breaker class or contactor class is able to withstand short time current because they feel, of course, the systems might be in use everywhere, but they feel it will not comply with -6-1. That's why the sequence is not indicated here. So the main advantages of using the PC class is all in one. First of all, there is an integrated ATS, which leads to high mean time between failures. It's possible to have live motor replacement. Motor is one of the parts which helps transition from source one to source two and vice versa. It is characterized with low mean time to repair, MTTR. High short circuit withstand values, conformity to the standard, no issues with selectivity, and it helps in segregation of the transfer function versus protection. Circuit breakers are the best devices for protection. They are irreplaceable. But when it comes to transfer, there has to be a designated PC class transfer switching. It's possible to have manual operation with very much ease. Inherent mechanical interlocking is there because a changeover switch always has got a mechanical interlock. And this is the basic building block for transfer switching equipment. There are three mechanically stable positions in case of TSC, which is not in the case of contactors. We have two positions, third position is not there. A simplified architecture, and it's a totally maintenance-free design. So we have this formula for any critical installation. there is a discussion about uptime. In fact, there is an institute in the US which the name of the institute is Uptime Institute, which talks about the availability of power for critical infrastructure. As per the Uptime Institute formula, availability is defined as 1 minus MTTR divided by MTBF. So where MTTR is the total repair time. I'll explain this in this very intuitive slide, as you can see. So imagine if there is a situation, any appliance has been working, that is the available time. And then there is a problem in the device, which leads to maybe, for example, in ATS, there is a problem in the motor. And then it takes some time to repair. So basically, MTTR is the total repair time from the inception of the fault to the overall repair. And then once this problem is attended to, the system restores back to original state of working. From this, we can find the availability time, in which is in green, is impacted due to this problem. And also important is how much repairing time it takes. So mean time to restore MTTR is a combination of intervention time plus the repairing time. It's defined as non-availability. For level 4 data centers, because once you have this formula, you will have a figure something like, in terms of percentage, it would be 99.9 or something. In tier 4 data centers, they talk of availability, which is called as 4 nines or 5 nines, means the availability has to be 99.999% of the time. Then only it is considered a good facility which is capable of handling high reliability networks. Now, my colleague would be covering MTBF and MTTR in more detail, but what some empirical studies have shown is typically transformer has a MTBF of 2 million hours and an MTTR of about 24 hours. So, I mean, these figures vary from time to time, but this is just some analysis which has been carried out. Withdrawable circuit breaker is about 262,800 hours. The transfer switching equipment, the switch has MTBF of 876,000 hours, mean time to repair of 10 hours, and motor. With this empirical study, we have done a sequential analysis about how much availability is impacted when we do a class PC-based transfer versus a circuit breaker-based transfer. And as you can see, when we use a circuit breaker-based transfer, we have a power availability of 99.957%. But with transfer switching, it improves by 1/9. It becomes, so it's something like we have, with this empirical formula, in 1 year, we are having an unavailability of 4 hours in case of circuit breaker based transfer, but it's hardly 20.22 hours in case of transfer switching with PC class, which is compliant to -6-1. So it's almost 18 times higher availability with the TSC based system, which is all for availability. Another synopsis about the standards, which will give an entire summary of what the standard is all about. We have the general standard IEC 60947, which covers all the LV products, the general rules -1. We have the class CB circuit breaker, which is the -2 standard. It takes care of overload, short circuit, tripping. And then we have the switch disconnector class PC, a load break switch. The function is isolate, open and close, withstand short circuit. Different classes of utilization are there, AC23 being inductive and 21 being resistive. -4 is for contactors, which is a CC class here. Frequent switching is there. So as you know, contactor has a very high mechanical cycle life. I mean, it can handle number of mechanical cycles and sustain motor overloads. And it's got AC1, AC2, and AC3 for inductive. But the green band here shows that there is a new standard now for multifunction equipment, that which is the -6-1 standard for transfer switching, where the functionality includes isolation, open and close occasionally, and most important, withstand short circuit. And it has got these classes of AC31 utilization category for resistive and AC33 for terminal loads or tertiary loads where there are power factor banks are far away is AC33, where the power factors are pretty low. So in case of transfer switching, there is a clear distinction in the standards because of the different functionality and expectations of safety and high reliability. I'll play a small video to just let you have a very basic but highly reliable technology for So we have a double break, fast opening and closing each pole, and it's got PC sliding contact. It gives stable positions, constant pressure contacts to withstand heavy short circuits, contacts that are not affected by any variations or vibrations, protection against the risk of welding. And these are maintenance free because there are no separate arcing contacts which need to be replaced to bear the brunt, because there's a sliding type wiping action which takes care of the removal of the carbon deposits during the operation itself. So that's why it's totally maintenance free design. There's no need to replace the contacts. Arc chamber is there which directs the arc into the shoot and extinguishes. No stagnation of the contacts. So very simple and reliable, time tested design. And so much is the, I would say, the beauty is in the detail. Here, there is the asynchronicity between the closing of poles is less than 50 microseconds. So if we were to see in an oscilloscope, the time gap between the closing of one pole with respect to other, the gap is just 50 microseconds. So this is the level of mechanical engineering detailing which is necessitated. Otherwise, there is always a risk of circulating currents. Fully independent switching mechanism, and it's independent of the user operating speed. I'm trying to emphasize on these details just to let you have an idea about how much reliable the system is. So that you'll be able to find from this linkages video. So in synopsis, the transfer function complies to IEC 60947-6-1 class PC, which is the most specified transfer class worldwide and suitable for isolation. This is another important thing. Actually, it's one thing to be complying to -6-1 standard, but another very important feature which is, I would say, a collateral advantage is because it's based on the switch design. That's why a PC class of transfer switch, which is based on the switch disconnector principle, is also complying to IEC 60947-3 implies that once it is put in zero position and padlocked, then one could do downstream maintenance without any risk of residual current leakage. So that makes it truly very safe. And isolation requirements because of 3F testing, contact clearance distance, position indicators, and all the products are tested for end of line performance so that what you get on your mounting board is something which is really been tested and validated before. We also have a very veritable manual transfer switching range. I'm sure all of you would have been hearing about Socomec range of on-load changeover switches for high reliability for so many years and maybe a few decades as well. So this got application in building segments, data centers, telecom, railways, because everywhere there's a requirement to have a manual changeover switch where safety and reliability is of utmost importance. We have a wide range, even in the manual range, where we have the Serco-AM modular from 16 to 125. We have the visible contact switch range for changeover, the COMO CS range from 25 to 100 ampere. There is the flagship range from 63 ampere to 3200 ampere, which we call as the Circover. There's a bypass which is used as a device for UPS externally up to 1600 ampere. And manual transfer switching range, there's a new version which has been launched recently with spreaded contacts. And there is also a version with enclosed solutions. So even the manual switch is complying to Dash 6-1 standard. It's available in 3-pole as well as in 4-pole. And it's quite durable, adaptable. And these are the various accessories. I mean, there are direct handles, external handles, IP55, switch bodies, interface barriers, auxiliary contacts, all well-defined parameters. And now something more is there is a huge population of Socomec changeover switches in the market, which have been replaced with the internationally acknowledged and Dash 6-1 compliant Circover range. Now, with the new range of Circover from B3 to B5 frames, which had been launched a few weeks back, we also have a retrofit kit. So in case there is an installation of old range of changeover switch from 125 ampere to 630 ampere anywhere, then using this retrofit kit of Socomec along with the new Circover with the spreaded terminals, it's possible to fit this new range onto the mounting location of the existing changeover switch. So this would enormously increase chances of replacing a Socomec product with a Socomec with a new mounting leg accessories and offset couplers and interlock assemblies. So it's about robustness, minimum downtime, minimum modification required with the offset couplers and new mounting legs and copper seal links. I have now finished my part of the presentation, and I hope you would have found some of the content quite insightful and useful. And please feel free to post your questions through the COSMA organizers. And I would now thank for your patient hearing and request the COSMA organizers to hand over to Mr. Anish. And at the end of Mr. Anish's session, we will be taking all the questions one by one. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your patient hearing.
Mr. Deepesh, kindly introduce to Mr. Anish, and Anish Bhai's presentation will start. Because he was answered your screen, so Anish can share his screen. Thank you.
Thanks, Vigar Bhai. Your wonderful presentation, PC classes, maintenance free contacts, simple and reliable system, self-explained videos. It was a wonderful presentation. It is well explained.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. Thank you for your time, sir.
Dipesh ji, I want to add something here.
Okay, sir. Tell me, sir. Tell you.
Sorry, I am joined late because of some other engagement with my company. Here, I want to mention SOCOMEC is a huge well-wisher of COSMA. In our COSMA convention held on October 2013, today's speaker, Vikas Tyagi, he knows me well and I know him well.
Yes.
He had presented papers on ATS in 2013.
Yes.
Also, they have put on many occasions advertisement in our COSMA Elcrema special edition magazines. As well as COSMA appreciate their cooperation and participating in our activities. It will be out of place if I don't mention name of Chitra Devi for her huge role in engagement of COSMA. That's all my prior side. Thank you, Vikas ji. I missed your presentation, but I will cover it up.
Thank you, Mr. Sanjeev, for remembering because you are attending so many sessions. Still, you remembered something long back. It's really appreciated and heartfelt. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, I know you because you are a classmate of my partner. you are studied in KRAC. My partner
yes,
studied in from KRAC. When you visited our factory, that time yes. We had a detailed discussion on that. That's why these things go into green memory, like, you know, cannot
you,
be
thank,
forgotten.
You know? Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Dipesh, now over to you. You take care of it.
Yeah, sir. Thank you. Sanjeev, sir, is our national president. Okay, thank you, sir. Now, I would like to introduce Mr. Anish Gopalakrishnan. He's having more than 14 years of rich experience in pre-sales support, sales and marketing, business development, technical marketing, and technical support. Anish Gopalakrishnan has been associated with SOCOMEC Innovative Product Solutions as specification manager for last 3 years, overseeing the company's business goals, specification, and market development. Besides, he is responsible for promotion of new products and solutions in PSM. PSM means power switching and monitoring domain. Okay. Anish ji, we are waiting for your wonderful presentation.
Thank you, Divesh ji, for the introduction. A very good afternoon to all the COSMA participants and a warm welcome to this webinar. I will just share my screen. Please confirm you are able to see it.
Yes, it is visible. Yes.
Yeah, before starting, am I audible and my screen is visible?
Perfect.
Okay. Okay, thank you. So, and thank you, Vikasi, for presenting a detailed overview on the standards applicable, our SOCOMEC TSC technology, then the MTSC range, which is there, and rather, I would say, proudly made in India product, MTSC. So now, second part of this webinar, we will see the versatile range of ATSCs and the RTSCs, which gives more flexibility in the transfer switching application. To set the context, I will do a brief introduction on TSC. Then we will go into some specific range, which is from 125 to 3200 ampere, which is called ATIS range. Then we will have a special focus on the latest product, which has been developed and marketing will be done specifically for India, which is the ATIS ANC packages. Then we will see some of the key features of SOCOMEC ATIS, what is the advantages which you will be getting by using SOCOMEC ATIS. Then finally, what all are the benefits as a panel manufacturer or a control panel manufacturer, you will be able to get it. So to start with the introduction, so we all know that in today's world that, okay, all the critical applications, like say, be it a healthcare facility or a server room or a production line, it will be backed up by a secondary source or the alternate source. So that, okay, the power availability is given to that to avoid all the incidents or the losses which occur due to, it can be a commercial loss or it can be personal safety. So we have to have a transfer of source happening in case of an unavailability of the first source. So what a transfer switch does? The transfer switch does the transfer between the primary source and the alternate source. The transfer switch does that.
I request other members to keep their mic on mute so that we can enjoy this session. Yeah, Anish, continue.
Thank you, Vishalji. So basically, the function of a transfer switch is to transfer the source and continually supply the power to the load. However, there are two things which we need to take into consideration when we do the transfer application. One is it has to meet the availability condition. So when I talk about availability condition, let us assume that the primary source is not available. The transfer switch has to transfer to the backup source. Say in this case, it is shown as a generator. So what happens is that it should only transfer when the voltage or the frequency and the phase sequence are in line with the primary source. Otherwise, it is a damage. It can cause a damage to the load. So that is the availability condition which it has to ensure. Second thing is it should be safe of operation to the maintenance team. So this transfer switch application, Mr. Vikasyagi has already mentioned regarding the withstand capacities and how it functions in a short circuit. So during any abnormal situations, the transfer should not cause any problem to the operating personnel, for the people or the equipment. So when I talk about Socomec transfer switch, we are now in the fifth generation of transfer switch. We more than 5 decades of experience we are having in the transfer switch equipment. The widest range of transfer switches available in the market as on date, that is from 16 ampere up till 6300 ampere. And the MTBF, we are having up to 90 years. So when I simplify how 90 years MTBF functions is that, let us assume that 100 numbers of TSE is being installed throughout the year. It is continuously working for a year. Less than one number will be only having some issue. So that is the kind of quality which Socomec ensures when in manufacturing of each TSE. And we have been continuously evolving in the market. That is why we are today in the fifth generation in 2020s. It started all the way back from 50s. So our main focus is the safety, quality, and the reliability. And all over the globe, we have installed about 3 million of transfer switch till date. So our key attributes, which is safety, reliability, and the quality, which will lead to long-lasting products. We have seen products which has been in service for more than 20 to 30 years.
Excuse me, distorted. Someone is coming, please.
Am I audible?
Yeah, Anish, you are audible. I think there was some echo sound. So you can.
Okay. So when we talk about the complete transfer switching equipment offer, we can categorize it into three. One is the manual transfer switching equipment, which has been covered by Mr. Vikas Tyagi. That is from 16 ampere to 3200 ampere, available in 3-pole and 4-pole version. We have certain, for certain applications, we have certain bypass as well as overlapping contact versions available for the manual transfer switching equipment. And since we our principal design is same, this will be the most rugged product available in market today. The second type of transfer switch is the remotely operated transfer switching equipment, which ranges from 40 ampere to 6300 ampere, again available in 3-pole, 4-pole versions. This can be converted into automatic transfer switching application by use of an external controller or maybe certain complex features. It can be used along with the PLC. And it is a maintenance free design, most of the product which is available with Socomec. Then the last type of transfer switch is the automatic transfer switching equipment, which is starting from 40 ampere up till 3200 ampere. Which is a single solution for a purpose-built all-in-one product. You just need to connect the control as well as the power wiring for getting the transfer function happening. Then finally, we have certain range, which is I'll just go into the next slide with the range which is there. So we have some ready-made product which is compliant to IEC 61439 standard as well as 60947-6-1 standard, which is called the enclosed bypass. This is used in very critical application wherein the customer does not need any interruption when the ATS compartment is taken out for some maintenance purpose. So generally, no brake transfer is done to the bypass for any maintenance when it is done in this. So that is available from 40 ampere to 3200 ampere. Then we have the highest rating ATS available in market, that is from 4000 ampere to 6300 ampere. If someone is interested in knowing more about this product, we can have a separate session with them. So today we'll be mostly focusing on the ATS range, which will be the RTSC as well as the ATSC range from 125 to 3200 ampere. Apart from that, for fit out jobs, we have ATS M range, which starts from 40 to 160 ampere. Mostly it is most compact thing, which can be mounted in a din rail. So your panel size, your cable termination, everything will be very simplified in this product. And Sircover is already covered by Mr. Vikas Sagi for manual transfer application. So Sircover range per se is starting from 63 to 3200 ampere. We also have a remote transfer switch in the lower rating, which is 40 ampere to 125 ampere by means of ATIS S. So let us focus on ATIS 125 to 3200 ampere range. So when we talk about the range of ATIS range of TSC, there are two variants variants available. One is the RTSC, which is called ATIS R, which is compliant to 60947-6-1 standard. The second range is the ATSC, which is the purpose-built ATIS range. ATIS A and C, which we'll be seeing in the coming slide, which is we can proudly say that it is developed and made for India, which will have an integrated controller, the wiring harness, as well as the voltage tags. Then ATIS G, which is with integrated controller, which will have some more functionality, and also what I can say is that simple in configuration. Then the most high-end model is the ATIS P, which will have certain additional features apart from the other two ATIS range. So let us see what is ATIS R. It is a remote transfer switching equipment, which will have a mechanically held contacts. It will have three stable position. The third position, that is source one, source two, and zero. The third position, zero position, we can do a padlocking for safe operation during plant maintenance. And this is compatible with any of the external controllers or the PLCs, which is available in the market for giving a command and then doing the transfer. So as we have seen earlier, this will not have intelligence on its own. So we have to have a separate programming done for sensing both the sources. Then once the unavailability is happening, then those command has to be given separately. So it will take the command and act on its own. So, or it can also be connected using a push button, wherein a control will be given through a push button station. So a person manual intervention will be required during that operation. One of the most important advantage here is the wideband voltage, which is available for the motor, so that it works as low as 166 volt to maximum of 332 volt single phase power supply, so that you don't need a separate stabilizer for use of RTSC. And say suppose any emergency happens, suppose let us assume that this motor, due to some reason, it is not functioning, we can put it onto manual and insert the handle, which is already supplied along with the RTSC, and operate it in manual mode and put it onto the desired source. So the main concern of many end users, which we see, is that ATIS can be, or ATS can be, a single point of failure. So in this case, we can proudly say that this product will not become a single point of failure because of its manual operation possible. Now, how do we make this ATIS R into for ATS application? So when we see for mains to mains, that is transformer to transformer, or mains to genset application, we can use ATIS C25 controller, which is one of the basic controller available with Socomec. Or in case you don't need any communication, you can go with the ATIS A15 controller. With that, we can make for this mains and mains genset application, the ATS functioning performing. When it comes to genset application, that is between two genset, you want to do a transfer. Additional complex controls like say starting of the DG for both the sources will be required. So in that case, we have extended controller, which is a C65 or C55 controllers available with us, which can be supplied for these applications. Now, when we go to Atis G, the Atis G will have all the functionalities of Atis R. Apart from that, we can also use the DG start command. There is a contact which is available with Atis G, which can give to the DG control panel for the starting of the generator. Secondly, the configuration can be done using a small screwdriver because the settings is possible using the potentiometers which is available on the controller, as well as the dip switches, which can be seen on the controller. Then this also senses the voltage, frequency, and the phase rotation. Also, it will do the auto configuration of the neutral. So you don't need to separately configure it for the neutral configuration. So it will do auto configuration, which will reduce the time for installation. Now, this will have additional display unit. Socomec provides additional display unit, which is called D10 display, which is an intuitive display, which will show using LEDs. This can be mounted onto the door of your panel and see the status of which source it is in or which position the transistor is in, whether the source is available or unavailable. All those informations can be seen on the front of the panel. So it is very easy to commission and all-in-one ITS, which we give with Atis G. Now, with respect to the communication option, we can give an add-on module, which will communicate over RS-485 communication. This is the same module which we use for Atis P range. What are the parameters which we can see on this controller? That is source availability and health, Atis availability and which position it is in, the configurations which has been set in, and the timers which has been put in, then different alarms. So all this configuration, as I said earlier, it is very easy to do with dip switches as well as using the potentiometers. Now the topmost range available with Socomec is Atis P. So Atis P will have additional configurable inputs apart from Atis G. It will have an intuitive display which can be used for programming of the parameters. More flexibility it offers with respect to the settings of the parameters, be it a voltage settings or be it frequency settings or be it the voltage sensing settings. Then it will also come with a real-time clock, which will have a timestamping event on the events. We can also program the engine exerciser so that a periodical programming can be done. So, say example, we can do the operation of the transfer switch and then check whether the DG is running. So those can be set on a periodical way as a planned functionality test during maintenance. So that can be done. Then we can also connect CTs, standard CTs can be connected and then have the measurements seen on the display or extended onto the D20 display. Although most of you will be using metering solutions for it, this is an additional feature which we give along with Atis P. It will have a communication option of either RS-485 communication or Ethernet communication. In Ethernet communications, the web server feature is available so that you can have the data on the web page. Again, it is an all-in-one solution. You don't need to have a separate controller required for this. You will be only connecting the control wiring as well as the power connection. So additional one feature which is available is the load shedding option, which can be done in case of any, if you are using it for not 100% backup, you want to do some load shedding through a certain context, we can do the load shedding. Then external inhibition. Say suppose a fault is occurred in the system. So during the fault, you don't want to transfer the transfer switch to the alternate source because the fault will get again replicated. So it, for that, we can have a logic formed with this transfer switch and give a command onto the transfer switch to not to do any transfer application in case it detects a fault. Then additional features which is possible is test on load. That means it will do the testing of a full transfer. That means the what the TSC will do is that it will operate a full cycle by even start giving a DG start command. And then once the power has come to the DG, it will do the transfer to the DG and then it will switch off the DG. Same way, test offload command, wherein the transfer application doesn't happen, but the genset start and stop command, whether it is working or not, it will do the checking. Engine exerciser, I already explained it, which can be set periodically. Now we will focus on the ATIS A and C packages. So when we talk about ATIS A and C packages, say you have seen the ATIS R remote transfer switching equipment. So how we can make an ATIS R RTSC into an ATSC? By means of using ATIS controller, which can be A15 or a C25 controller, then using a cable harness and some voltage sensing tags. So this solution is being tested as per IEC 60947-6-1 as an ATS. So what is the advantage you are getting? It is a cost effective solution which you are getting, and all the more you are getting a automatic transfer switch. So this is a combination. We'll see it in the next slide. So if you see that the wiring harness is being connected and the controller is giving the command based on the availability, sensing and availability, it will give the command. And then it is having the voltage sensing tags, which will sense the power supply at both the sources. The advantage here is that it will sense all the three phase loads. Unlike certain manufacturers only give a single phase sensing, we give three phase sensing. Then all the features of ATIS R, that is the padlocking in zero position, then mechanical interlock, which is an inbuilt mechanical interlock, all those things, advantages are you are getting along with the solution. Also, you can see that the length of this cable, it is long enough. It's more than 2 meter long cable, the harness wiring, so that you can easily terminate that to the door. The controller can be terminated onto the door. It will also have the IP rating of 4X for the door mounting. And it will have the ATIS controller will have a dual power supply. I'll explain it in the coming slide. And DG start command also is possible using the contact which is available in the controller. So this solution is a complete solution which has been tested as ATIS A and C along with the controller, the wiring harness, the voltage sensing tags. Now, when I talk about the controller, it's a very simple controller. Again, dip switch configuration is available for setting the voltage thresholds, the frequency thresholds, and the timers, which is required for transfer and retransfer. Then it is having dual power supply, integrated dual power supply. That means it will take the feedback from EB, or the primary source and the secondary source, and it will sense it so that in no way you are losing any supply for transfer or retransfer application. And it is self-powered, so we have to give the control signal, the DPS signal to be to the controller, and the wiring, only one output goes to the motor of the RTSC. For ATIS C25 controller, we have a communication option of RS-485, which can communicate the status of the TSC, the operation counts, how many times the TSC has been in position one and position two, operating hours, etc. So those parameters are the minimum which can be communicated over RS-485. So this will be very useful for people who are monitoring the system, which is available like say example, if I take a data center, you'll be having BMS systems wherein they will be monitoring all the statuses of various equipments, be it a metering solution or be it a breaker status or be it a TAC status. So those can be integrated onto using this C25 controller. So the standard which the TAC controller complies to is IEC 61010-2-210, which is for the safety, and 60947-6-1 when tested along with the ATIS R, the voltage sensing kit, and the wiring harness. So it is ATIS A and ATIS C. It is tested with the C25 controller. ATIS A is with A15 controller, ATIS C is with C25 controller. Then I explained already regarding the EC configuration of the voltage, the network, the type of network, whether it is a three-phase or a single-phase network, what is the timing, the time setting which is possible for the source 1 and source 2, that is possible. Then the priority we can set it for source 1 or without a priority. So when I set it for without priority, once the transfer switch transfer to the second source, it will keep on staying in the second source until it sees unavailability of that source. So retransfer doesn't happen. Whereas when we set a priority as S1, once the source 1 comes back, the retransfer happens and it comes back to source 1. So as I said earlier, we have RS-485 communications possible in a C25 controller, which can be taken over to Socomec Dieris M70 gateway or the D70 display, which will have inherent web page, web server availability, and the data can be seen on that web gateway. Or on Ethernet, we can take this output to the BMS wherever required by the customer. So I talked about the voltage sensing tags. Let us see which all are the voltage sensing tags which is available in ATIS A and C range. So we have different frame sizes available depending on the rating. So B3, B4, B5 frames are from 125 to 630 ampere, wherein you can see that these all are the voltage sensing tags which is available. So B4 and B5, we have two variants of voltage sensing tags to which the wiring harness is clipped on. Whereas for B6, B7, and B8, which is from 800 to 3200 ampere, we have a provision provided in the terminal itself, wherein directly we can connect the wiring harness and have the sensing of the voltage. Now, when we talk about the harness, this is very simple in connection, error-free connection. You can do it with this wiring harness. These all are the clip-ons which will go into the terminals or the voltage sensing tags. These terminals are easily connectable to the controller and the RTSC. So this comes as a ready built solution. Only two part numbers, which is simplifying the inventory for the dealer or be it a panel builder. So two part numbers, one is for up to 630 and the other is up to 3200. So which all ratings which is available that we have seen, that is 125 to 3200 ampere is the rating which is available for ATIS A and C. The type of switches available is four pole switches only. Because of line load reversibility of feature available with our TSC, top or bottom we can give the sources, and the other side we can give the load. In this particular case, the neutral will be on the right because the sensing has been pre-configured with neutral on right. The controllers are available are two variants, A15 without communication and C25 with communication. And part numbers you can see on the packaging, it will be starting with 95915 or 9525 for ATIS A and C. And the entire the package is being tested for ATS application, which is automatic transfer switch application according to DIA 6-1 standard. So now going forward, we will see some of the key features of SOCOMAC-ATIS. So one is the robustness. We have seen how the contacts have been done. So if you see that, okay, we have been manufacturing from more than 50 years this transfer switching equipments. So the long lasting reliable solutions we are providing, and there are certain cases wherein the transfer switch is installed from 70s, which is still working. The compliance standard, it has been tested in 960947-6-1, which is the standard, international standard for TSE. In addition, it is also compliant to -3 standard, which is the standard for switch disconnector standard, which will give additional options of having the isolation function, then safe operation provision, etc. Now it will have three stable positions, as we've seen earlier, 1, 0, 0 or off, and the second source position. So it is not also affected by voltage fluctuation because of the wide voltage range which is available for the motor or the controller. Second is ease of use. So it is very easy to use. The configuration is very easy. Auto sensing of neutral is available in a certain range. So even the programming is easy, either through our EC config software for ATIS-P or through dip switch and the potentiometer setting for ATIS-G, or the dip switch setting for the C25 or A15 controller. So it is very easy. And the detection of voltage and frequency is auto detection, it does. And the network type selection or phase rotation or the neutral position, it is easily selectable using SOCOMAC-ATIS. Third point is the reliability. So when we, which is the most important thing which you need to have as a panel manufacturer, because you should not be getting more and more complaints from the product, so that your service engineer will be doing more visits to the site, which will eventually lead to time and money loss for you. So first thing is that the class PC self-cleaning contacts, so it does not require any maintenance throughout its life. And replacement of motor can be done online or the controller for that matter, without having shut down the main power supply. So with a mere loosening of four screws, we can replace the motor online without taking any shutdown by putting the source into the desired source position, so that your customer is also not annoyed because of non-availability of power during the maintenance. Because if you see the back design, the basic design is a manual transfer switching equipment on which a motor has been attached. So with manual operations, it can be put into the desired source position. Then fault indicator. So a fault indicator is nothing but it will have a watchdog relay, which will monitor the healthiness of the motor and the electronics. And it will give an information to us by means of indication. It is not functioning, so that preventive step can be taken for doing the replacement of the damaged parts. So genset starting latching relay, that is basically for ATIS-G, C and A, wherein we can have the command, the electronic command will be gone to the DG control panel using a latching relay. So that once the main supply fails, it will automatically give a command for the DG to start and then ensure the availability of the availability of power supply to the load. Now, safety is one key feature which SOCOMAC thrives on. So wherein manual emergency operations, which we discussed, that is in case of any electronics or motor failure, we can put the latch, the key for a key onto manual mode and insert a handle and do an operation manually, that to on load. So you don't need a separate isolation device in the downstream for switching. as it is already tested for Dash 3 standard. Second, we discussed about all-in-one solution. The mechanical interlock comes inherent with between the two load break switches. So there is no additional mechanical interlocks which you have to do during installation. And it is a factory tested product as a single device. Padlocking. So in off position, we can do the padlocking. In case you need to do padlocking in any one of the position, we provide certain accessory which can be put in onto for padlocking in three different positions, that is 1, 0, or 2. Product information is available because thanks to its watchdog relay availability, we can get to know whether the product is functioning okay or not. The contacts, due to its sliding contact wiping action, no maintenance is required throughout its life. And online motor replacement, wherein you don't need any shutdown for replacement of this controller or the motor requirement. So your downtime for maintenance is very much reduced. So when we compare the USB and the feature, ATIS-R is a remote transmitter switching equipment which will have a mechanically held contact. Three stable positions is available, 0, 1, and 2. It is compatible with varied controllers which is available in the market. Wideband voltage is available so that you don't need a separate stabilizer for having a stabilization of the voltage. Three position, that is 0, 1, and 2. And auxiliary signaling, we can have it so that we will know that, okay, which position the contact has been available. Then manual emergency onload operation, so that in case of any issue with the motor or the motor, we can do a, manual operation possible, that to onload. And watchdog relay, which will continuously monitor the healthiness of the motor. When we talk about the ATIS A and C, all these functionalities of ATIS R will be there. Plus, there is a possibility of selection of mains or mains genset application, depending on the your requirement. Then in case you need a 24 volt DC optional controller power supply, we can give with 24 volt optional power supply. IP4X protection for the controller when mounted on the door. Self-powered, that means the DPS from the both the sources, the sensing is taken to the controller and only one output goes to the motor, wherein you only need to give the supply to the controller alone. Then RS-485 communication option available on ATIS-C, that is seat with the C25 controller. Now, when we talk about ATIS-G, all the functionalities of ATIS R will be available. Plus, again, the mains or mains genset application possible. It is very easy to do the configuration using dip switches or the potentiometers. RS-485 communication option is given as an optional module. Again, this also will have integrated dual power supply. And genset test also, we can do it onload or offload. Then we can have also a display for having the status on the panel. ATIS-P will have all the functionalities of ATIS-G. With additionally, it will have a load shedding function. It will have a programmable engine exerciser function. Number of configurable inputs and outputs is available. Real-time event recording is possible. Then metering, in case some customer asks for a metering function, it is possible with this using standard CTs. Then WebView also is provided along with this, wherein Ethernet communication is given for this ATIS-P. So now by using all this ATIS, what are the benefits you as a panel builder is getting it? So one is ease of installation. So how you are having an ease of installation? One is line load reversibility. So line load reversibility makes it easier for you to terminate the bus bar. So if it is either bottom or top, it is reversible, so you don't have any issue. Second is ease of wiring. So I talked about the harness which is available with us. So this will minimize your wiring issue, as it is already pre-configured and compatible with our controllers, which can be clipped onto the voltage tags. And it reduces your control wiring time. It also reduces the errors which can cause when you're doing the installation of ATIS along with the controller and when doing the control wiring. There is no separate mechanical interlock you need. So it comes as a complete product with two switches as well as the mechanical interlock. So that again reduces your time for having a mechanical interlock. When I talk an example of say using breakers, when you do custom built functionalities of a transfer switch, what happens is that the mechanical or as well as the electronic electrical interlocks which you need to do, and also all the programming, all the wiring has to be done, which is more time consuming, I would say. The last one for ease of installation is the flexible mounting. So you can see that okay, different ratings, that is 125 to 630 and 800 to 3200. We are giving different options which is available for mounting. So whether it is horizontal or whether it is vertical. So three types of configuration possible in each of the types. So that is possible so that the bus bar termination as well as the control wiring complications are minimized when you are doing the installation of this device. Second benefit is the certified product. So the ATIS as a whole, it has been certified according to 60947-6-1 standard. And when used along with the ATIS ANC controllers, it will be certified as ATS. Second important point is, say you all, I know most of you will be doing IEC 61439 panels. So the 61439 panel integration is possible with Socomec ATIS, and Socomec website will give the guide, technical guide on recommendation how to integrate, and also how without losing selectivity you can integrate Socomec TSC onto various switchgear manufacturers type tested panels. So that is possible. Third point is ease of maintenance. So we have discussed regarding maintenance fee design of the contacts. So throughout its life, you don't need any maintenance for the switches. Online motor replacement, so that the customer will have that flexibility that, okay, no power is unavailable when you're doing the replacement of motor, or for that matter, the electronics like the controller. And the time required for replacing is also very minimal. Third is the isolation function. So suppose your technicians are working downstream doing some replacement of MCCB or some switch gear, or say doing some bus bar modification work during planned maintenance. You can put the transfer switch into zero position and then padlock with three different padlocks, one for the technician, one for the supervisor, and one for the manager, so that necessary safety is ensured to the downstream technicians who are working on the panel. The next advantage is the warehouse management, EC warehouse management. So we have very not very complicated part numbers, very less part numbers available with the Socomec range of ATIS depending on the rating. Whereas if you see the wiring harness also, we have simplified it into only two part numbers for the entire range. So the inventory requirement is very easy. And you can do the mix and match of, say, you are keeping a common controllers, say, ATIS A15 or A25, C25. So the inventory requirement is minimum. You can use an ATIS R along with the voltage sensing tags and the harness along with the controller and get it certified for ATS according to 60947-6-1 standard. Then another advantage is that be it from Socomec or be it from the channel partners, you will get better lead time because of a mix and match of common components, and also speedier delivery. Because of speedier delivery, you will be able to get your panel manufacturing done very fast. So to summarize on the ATIS range, so ATIS-R, as we have seen, it is a remote RTSC, remotely controlled using either PLC or a controller or any Jensen controller. ATIS-ANC is a purpose-built, custom-built, or rather I can say that, okay, made for India, developed in India product, which can be used for various applications, certified as ATS with integrated dual power supply, and it it covers all the bells and whistles of the requirement for an ATIS. ATIS-G, going one step ahead, wherein you have certain additional functions like genset control application or any Modbus communication option, and some remote monitoring options. And also it will have a very simple configuration for the settings as well as dipsuit settings. The most advanced is the ATIS-P, the same product which is seen in our ATIS bypass enclosures. So it is fully programmable, easy to configure using a Socomec EC config software, which can be downloaded from Socomec website, and very simple, more flexible, the wide varieties of settings possible for both the sources. And this is the most high-end product which is available at Socomec. So with this, I end my session. I hope much informations were passed on to you with respect to the product range which is available.
Thank you, Anishji. I request, it was an amazing presentation. I request Dipesh bhai, if you have any question, we should start with you as per Cosma culture.
We have some questions in the chat box.
Okay. No, you have. Mr. Dipesh is having any question?
No, it was wonderful. Well explained.
Okay. then we can ask, the first question was posted by our Vice Chairman, Mr. Sanjeev Lodha ji. So, Sanjeev bhai, please unmute and you can ask your question.
I'll have to check what did I ask at that time, because I have all many questions. I think it is written in the chat box. We can see it and reply.
Shall I read or you are asking?
I have written that. What is the difference between Socomec, what we are manufacturing, and the HPL range of MPSEs, which used to be made earlier and now they are making?
Yes, sir. This is Vikas Tyagi here. Good afternoon, Mr. Sanjeev.
Yeah,
actually, Socomec is the original manufacturer of these items. We introduced our manual as well as automatic switching products. Initially, when we came into India, then we were making these manual changeover switches and we supplied to HPL, and they were, we are thankful to them that they helped us distribute this in the marketplace in the brand name of HPL Socomec, but it was originally a Socomec product. Similarly, we supplied ATS also through them, but after a couple of years, their focus was different. Our focus was more into the specified market. So we separated amicably and we started marketing our range directly into the market, our range of manual as well as automatic transfer switches. But today they have their own range. So we had a good arrangement. They were our distribution partners, but the products had been originally conceptualized by Socomec France and later started manufacturing in India also.
So my question was this, that like the earlier HPL Socomec, wherever they were installed, those changeover switches, can they be replaced by Socomec now?
Yes, sir. That is why, sir, based on the voice of the customer, our old installation of changeover switch, that is why we have come up with a retrofit kit. So our new circover, when it is used along with the retrofit kit, initially we have started with the fast moving frames from B3 to B5. It could be, we have access to that market now.
So we have to use some kit
Yes, sir. Basically, you need to use our new switch along with the retrofit kit, and then the existing changeover switch could be replaced with the Socomec only, sir.
Fine. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Any more question, Mr. Vishal?
I request Mr. T.J. Sampath Kumar to ask his question. Is there LSIG protection in the switches? That is his question.
Can I answer this, sir?
Yes, please.
Yeah. So basically, a switch is meant for switching application only. It will not have any protection per se, be it overload, short circuit, or the earth fault protection. For that purpose, we'll be using the like the breakers like ACBs or MCCBs for that application. But say if I talk in simple terms, say in our home, we'll be using MCB for the short circuit protection and overload protection, whereas the switch will be used for switching application.
I will also add to this point. Actually, sir, when we, as Anish rightly explained, that switching and protection is segregated. In our ATS, we don't have protection. But one additional difference could be there. Instead of conventionally using electrically interlocked breakers, now in case of ATS, because ATS is doing the transfer, one could go for maybe manually operated breakers. So because there is no need for the breakers to transfer. So that could be one optimization, but of course the protection and transfer is segregated as per the IEC-6-1 standard. So.
Next question is by Mr. Santosh Sanay. Santoshji, you would like to ask the question or shall I read your question? Do you have the feature of single phase protection which will happen in any one of the phase?
Yes, sir. In fact, there is single phasing, phase rotation, phase imbalance, voltage thresholds, frequency threshold. When any of these conditions is compromised as per a set preference and programmed values, it will shift to the other source. So whenever a phase is lost, we have a provision, the ATS will shift to another source, a healthy source.
Okay, so certainly the chat books are over. But Mr. Ankit Gire, if you have any question, you can unmute and ask, no problem. Both 3-pole and 4-pole version is a
sir. Sir, in the ATS range, most of the families, we are having 3-pole and 4-pole versions, including in our manual version also. So both these versions are there.
Our president, Mr. Sanjeev Khinawar, is having one question. Yeah.
Right, sir.
Question is to Mr. Vikas Tyagi. Many times our competition speaks about overlapping neutral and then the close transition operation, other things.
Right, sir.
Many times a lot of argument takes on that.
Right, sir.
What is your view on those things actually?
The point where overlapping neutral came into place is for critical infrastructure. Whenever the devices by a particular manufacturer, 3-pole devices are being used and there's a need for neutral, then they came up with the overlapping neutral technology. We have found in our internal studies that when the poles are synchronized, and as I explained in my slide that there is hardly 50 microsecond gap between closing, then even in the most adverse conditions, the peak transient voltage which would develop is hardly 25 to 30 volts. And we have found that switch neutral is actually fully complying with the requirements, and the overlapping neutral is not required once the whole synchronicity is there.
Video on pandrena yaar kitta varadhi.
Anish, would you like to add something on this?
Yes, sir.
And similarly, on the other point, which is close transition.
Yeah. So basically, closed transition, when we talk about closed transition, both the sources has to be in sync when we have to do a closed transition operation. So the phase, the voltage thresholds, the frequency, and the phase sequence, it has to be in within that bandwidth when we talk about the closed transition application. The ATS, primarily its function is to transfer when the source is unavailable. So what happens is that when in closed transition, the source transfers from main source to alternate source in case of source unavailable. So there it happens in open transition only. The question comes only when the closed transition happens, when it is retransferring back to the main source. So for that, these three conditions have to be met, and the syncing of the sources has to be done, which is not allowed by the many, what you call the electricity supply companies for doing the syncing. First, second point, this particular application is very rare in certain industries wherein when they do process application, where they do a planned transfer for certain period of time. So that is the only application which we have seen for closed transition application. And all the more, when we talk about critical, what you call loads, all the most of the critical loads will be supplied using a UPS. So the UPS will never interrupt the load, the critical loads. So the since the ATS will be in the upstream of the UPS, whether it is open transition or closed transition, during this retransfer back, it is not going to affect any critical loads. Only the other loads, it will get affected. So closed transition, we have seen very rarely in India. Second, adding to overlapping neutral point, this question arises only when it is being connected downstream of the UPS. That is okay, the phases are available, neutral is not available. However, UPS installation also, we have different types of installation, whether it is with isolation transformer. In that case, there is no issue because the ATS will be in the upstream of the UPS. Secondly, there are certain UPS like Socomec manufacturer, certain UPS which will have electronically generated neutral. There is also no issue. Even we have tested in our laboratory along with what you call taking the input neutral reference to the output neutral, wherein there was no issue with respect to load voltage and the load current with while using Socomec UPS when we used a open transition switch. So maybe to clarify it, maybe we can have a separate discussion with you. We can show some slides over that explaining how it is functioned when we did the testing.
Yeah, thank you, Anish. And also, Mr. Sanjeev, there are these ground fault protection relays, and it's been found that unless this has been, the system has been configured and articulated properly, then there is always a risk of the ground fault nuisance tripping, which is not the case of switch neutral.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Now, if any, there is no more new question in the chat box. Sanjeev, you were speaking something.
Yeah. Now Chitraji has come on the in the session.
So now we can request.
I want to yes, thank her for always cooperating and participating in our activities. And
the pleasure.
And always honoring our appeals for Pasma News Magazine advertisements.
Sure, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You were not there when I mentioned all about this.
Okay.
Thank you.
So if there is no other question, we can give mic to Chitra ma'am.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Vishal. A very good evening to all of you. And maybe as some people may not be knowing, so I take care of the marketing and communication for Socomec India operations. So I thank Mr. Satish Kazi, founder, president, and chairman, and Mr. Sanjeev Kinava, president, Mr. Anand Jayavant, director, Mr. Ramani, director, Mr. Deepesh, vice chairman, Mr. Sudhir Hanumante, director, Mr. Vishal Sangvi, head electronic media, for giving us this wonderful platform and the opportunity to present the technical webinar session for the COSMO members, and seamless execution because we haven't had any technical glitches, fortunately, and we were able to present the information that we would like to share with the audience. I also thank our esteemed speakers, Mr. Vikas and Mr. Anish, for giving more insights about the transfer switching equipment. We hope the audience have found this session very interesting and useful. And thank you so much, you know, to all the audience who are being present here. You know, it is a great pleasure to have you with us. And we try to, our speakers have tried to address your queries, whatever you have raised so far. But in case if you have any queries further, please don't hesitate that you can always approach us. You can send your inquiries to the email ID we will post to info.in@socomic.com. Or we also have the expert care center number 1-800-203-0456. We will post that in the chat box. We will be glad to respond to your queries, whatever you may be having. So thank you so much once again for giving this you know, platform and the opportunity. And please be take care and stay safe. So now I hand over to Mr. Vishal. Thank you.
Thank you. I request our director, Mr. Sudhir Hanumante, to give a word of thanks.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Vishal. First of all, I would like to thank you, Mr. Vikram Dingra, Mr. Vikas Tyagiji, and Mr. Anish Gopalkrishnan for a really a wonderful session what they had, and the products what they have got. Though they have explained two products, there are so many variety in TC as well as ATS. And also I'm happy to know that, okay, these ATS are available up to 6,300 ampere. Really, congratulations to Socomac team. I would like to thank you, our Ramani ji, for our introduction of Cosma. I would like to thank our Mr. Dipesh, who is the vice chairman, for initiating this particular session, as well as giving a wonderful introduction of all Socomac team. I would like to thank our Mr. Sanju ji, President Cosma, and Satish bhai, Chairman Emirates, for attending this particular session and motivating all of us. Last but not least, I would like to thank Vishal and Director Mr. Anand Jaywan for making this session a full house, including our Dipesh for taking the initiative to this. And also I would like to thank all the participants for sparing their valuable time. And I'm sure this particular session was useful to all of you. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.